A money tree will take your stress away. Ballin' like every day. Call me coach, gotta switch up plays. Spend a little money, don't care how it made. Drop top, cool, catch sun ray. Started off without it, gotta get it one day. Doing 200 on the runway. Got a bad chick, and she ripping the runway. It's Super Bowl Sunday. Rip out my heart, you're a demon. I get the money for real no reason. Why everybody come through unpolitely? I ride around in exotic. Wake me up, cause I gotta be dreaming. If only my dogs could see this.
I ain't never had no money. I've been out here trying to get me away. Ain't nobody help when I was hungry. Fake friends, they just slipping away. Now I got it, so I ball. Man, like every day. For all the time, nobody helped me. Said I ball on you. Man, like every day. For all the time, you dated, man, I ball. Man, like every day. Until the day I pass away, I say I ball on you. Man, like every day. Man, like every day.
My whole team in a huddle, beating the bus. I done caught over a gazillion plays. Yeah, a legend now, not in the making. Breaking records, these are things we celebrate. Yeah, it took an L to keep you humble, humble. All that money start coming in late.
Today, from Levi's Stadium in Santa Clara, California, this is the National Football League. Jimmy Garoppolo and the San Francisco 49ers taking on Aaron Rodgers and the Green Bay Packers.
From the host of Super Bowl 50 back in February of 2016, there's a look at the home of the 49ers, Levi's Stadium in Santa Clara. The scene a short time ago, this crowd, they love their 49ers, and they were in full roar as their guys burst out of the locker room. And we're ready for football as the 49ers get set to do battle with the Green Bay Packers. Set to do the honors here, and we are underway from Santa Clara. And no run back here, so they'll bring it out to the 25. Out comes the San Francisco offense as they are led out by their quarterback, the man known as Jimmy G. That's Jimmy Garoppolo.
And Jimmy Garoppolo has shown that he can be a Super Bowl quarterback, but his biggest problem, his ability to stay healthy and remain on the field. When able, he's a capable quarterback prone to winning games both in the regular and postseason.
On first down, it's Mitchell, and he's up it.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
Right back to Mitchell on second down. And that play going absolutely nowhere as he's belted before he could get out of the backfield. They'll wind up losing three, and now it's third down.
We all have habits. We can be somewhat predictable, and you know me pretty well on second down and short. What I like to see?
Play action.
Yeah, without a doubt. I thought that was a great spot to call it. Instead, didn't go their way, did it?
No, defense sold out for the run. Worked out well. Third play here. This opening drive as they're up against a third and five. Looking to throw, Garoppolo. He'll get this complete to Charlie Werner. And he is going to have a 49ers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. To throw, it's Garoppolo. Toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes, but the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
On second down now, it's Mitchell. He'll get about three as he's brought down right around the 42. Pretty good little two-play sequence there. You force the incompletion, then a very short pickup.
Yeah, now maybe you bring in an extra defensive back or two because you want to try and defend on third down. They like to play those nickel or sub packages, don't they?
The first catch of the game for George Kittle. And he is going to have a Niners first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere. And they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well. And that's what they just did on that play.
So into Packer territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 45-yard line. Hands it off out of the gun. Fly. Another 13 yards there twice in a row, and they're on the move. Another first down as well. Relatively small sample size, but that's his longest run of the first quarter. Bounced it out to the outside to make it successful.
And to get there, you actually need some help. It's not just your pure speed getting to the corner, making sure that the blocking is taken care of inside so the pursuit doesn't get you. And oftentimes, those wide receivers, tight ends that might be flexed out, they've got to control the edge and make sure no one from the outside can spill the play before he gets there.
He's going to let this go. Back of the end zone. Toward the back corner of the end zone, but he could not get the feet down. This will wind up incomplete.
Not the desired outcome, but probably won't be the last time we see him take a shot downfield.
Jet sweep. Garoppolo taps it forward. And he's going to take this one down to the 25.
Times these plays, they either go for nothing or they go for big yardage. And here they got to the outside, turned it upfield, and ended up getting a nice little gain out of it.
Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Rashawn Gary in there to get him for a loss of 9 yards, and that also leads to fourth down. And that sack there, that likely brings out the field goal unit, so they might have to settle for three here on their opening drive.
They did some nice things getting things started there, moving the ball downfield, but taking that sack on third down, it lets the air out of the momentum balloon just a little bit.
So Garoppolo off, coming on is the veteran Robbie Gould for the 49er field goal. On the left hash, officially it's called a 51-yard attempt. And this is good. He got just enough to clear the crossbar as he drops it in from long distance. And the 49ers take a 3-0 lead. They were probably hoping to get him a little bit closer for a shorter field goal, but he was able to get it done from deep.
Nice little tester for him to begin things, huh? I think he was hoping for a little bit more of a chip shot. Instead, they made him stretch it out a little bit, but he's got to feel great now that he put it through the pipes.
And able to get this out to the 25. Time to see the offense for Green Bay go to work. Aaron Rodgers leading them. What a career it's been. Came into the league back in 2005 as the number 24 pick out of Cal.
I remember watching him in college and seeing a guy that you knew had great potential, but I don't know that anyone knew that we would see how he would blossom as an NFL player who will go down as one of the all-time great quarterbacks. Can make every throw from every angle with terrific mobility.
Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9. They'll run a toss here with Dillon. And he's upended after a gain of two out to the 27.
Sometimes you're aligned perfectly and the play comes to you, and sometimes you got to cover some ground to go make the play, as we just saw there.
We saw a great example of perseverance right there on that play.
Got to be careful. They might want to throw one over his head as this game progresses.
And he is going to have a Packers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Rodgers going to give this one to Dillon. And he'll power his way forward for about 4 yards there on the first down carry. 3-0 after one on EA Sports. The run got four. Now they deal with a second and 6. On play action, Rodgers. They find Randall Cobb on the completion. And this will move the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the 49ers 37. Rodgers now on first down. Open man, here's Cobb. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. This drive, it's been a good mix. 3 passing plays, 3 runs, hitting on all 3 of those passes, and the last one putting him in the red zone.
So wouldn't you think play action right here? Because you've got the ability and had the ability to run it and throw it. Go play action and take your shot at the end zone.
Here's a throw out wide complete to his running back right side. And so close, he gets it to the 1. Out of bounds right there.
And that's a nice job of working his way open down in the red zone. Looked that one in, and then made a beeline for the pylon. He didn't quite get there, and you wanted to give him a little extra for the effort, but instead he sets his guys up in excellent shape for the first and goal.
Jones is in. Touchdown, Packers. Aaron Jones punching it in from a yard away. And the Packers have taken the lead. So it was the passing game that got him down here, but closer to the goal line, it's the running game that gets him home.
Certainly appears that they lulled the defense into thinking that the passing game was going to be it the entire drive, not over the goal line.
On is Mason Crosby for the point after. And this is up and good to make it 7-3. So that drive goes 8 plays. And the last play in the drive was a touchdown run by Aaron Jones. Now after the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. The return man down to a knee, and this will come out to the 25-yard line. Back out there comes the 49ers offense, ready for their second drive. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game, are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. Mm-hmm. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they better make sure they love him up because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put six on the board here. We'll see. And he's taken down but able to slip across the 35.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Up here to his running back. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
I have a feeling they'll stay committed to running the football, especially on the early downs. They just haven't had a whole lot of success just yet.
On second and 11 now. Garoppolo throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
Trying for Ayuk, but it's intercepted. Picked off by Jair Alexander. And the Packers are going to have the short field here as they'll take over right at the 50.
And that's a great example of ball skills right there, partner. You and I do a lot of games, and I can't tell you how many guys look to run with the football before they've intercepted it. So that's a nice job of focusing on the task at hand and coming away with the interception.
So good field position for the Packers as they come up first and 10 right at the 50-yard line. So after the INT, it's Rod Blitz coming, and down he goes. Second and 20. Another try after the first down sack. Rodgers. He's going to rifle one deep left side. And that will be incomplete. Trying to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Rodgers with a give. It's Aaron Jones. And they'll get this across midfield, but not nearly close to a first down as he stopped at the 48. They get 13, but it's not nearly enough. And it'll be fourth down. Here's Corey Bohorquez to punt this thing away. Yards on the punt there, and the Niners will go on offense, first and 10. San Francisco's offense returns to the field, and following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
Garoppolo going to bring the Niners up here first and 10 at their own 16. From the gun, he'll hand this off. And he'll get this up to the 30-yard line. Quarter action with 1:59 remaining.
Here we go, here we go, here we go.
Coming up at halftime in a little less than 2 minutes, we'll send you to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman is standing by. He'll have highlights and analysis.
Trying for Ayuk, but it's intercepted.
Devondre Campbell, the linebacker, picks him. And his guys are going to get the football at the 37-yard line.
So that's back-to-back drives where they've thrown an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
That ball is caught. Marquez Valdes-Scantling. And they move this all the way down to the 9.
And remember, this drive started off following the turnover, and they've taken no time working their way down the short field. A nice connection there, and now they're looking at a first and goal.
And this carry brought to an end at the 8. Good stick skills, just not much room there to operate. Here's second and goal, operating from the 8-yard line. They'll try again with Jones. And just shy of the goal line as he's out of bounds right at the 1. 7 big yards on the carry there to get him within range of the goal line with third down upcoming. Decided to hand it off that time on the run pass option.
Appeared to be an easy decision.
They say it's a touchdown. Aaron Jones with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Packers add 6 to their lead. So his strong first half continues as he finds the end zone here for the second time.
And definitely good blocking at the point of attack, and you just have to love watching the way he can create space down near the goal line, and he's able to take it into the end zone.
Extra point try now for Crosby. And this one's right through to make it a 14-3 ball game. Just a 4-play drive that time. And the last play in the drive was a touchdown run by Aaron Jones. Now after the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. And this will not be brought out. It's a touchback. Here comes Jimmy Garoppolo now to lead his offense back out there. He and his team, they have had a rough go of it here in this first half. Maybe time for him to put his foot down here in the second quarter.
Put his foot down and become a little more accurate throwing the football. He's already thrown 2 interceptions. He's trying to find a way to equal things out. And instead of it going to the opponents, get it to his own receivers and find the end zone.
Yeah, you mentioned those 2 picks and no touchdown passes yet either. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. Garoppolo. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked off by Jair Alexander. 3 first half interceptions now, and Charles, you'd have to think a fair amount of concern is developing over there on that sideline.
And there should be, because essentially he's been a little loose and possibly reckless with the football here in the first half. Now maybe it's not all on him, but still 3 interceptions, that puts the entire team in jeopardy. So the play caller from here on out, got to design some throws for him that he can complete, keep it away from the defense, and try and get him back on track.
Rodgers will try again on second down. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off near the 32. And he will have a first down here as they get into field goal range, down just shy of the 20.
So first thing that crossed my mind is good shape.
Absolutely. And from this spot on the field, now you've given the other side a chance for points here going into intermission.
Yeah, you changed the momentum of the game, and it's something you did not need to do.
Deebo Samuel and the 49ers back in possession here. You better believe that he's well aware he has 0 catches right now, and they're losing, so he's probably a little hungry.
And you know the guys on defense are aware as well, and they're really excited that he has no catches, but they're also worried because a lot of times that's like the ticking.
And it's complete in the end zone. Touchdown, 49ers. Juwan Jennings there to make the grab. And the 49ers get a late score here in the final minute of the first half. Gold with the extra point, and the lead is down to four. Well, they got the ball in great field position. One play later, boom, end zone. After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gold now to kick it away. This fielded right at the goal line. And he will make it to the 20-yard line and no further. Here's Aaron Jones in the offense trotting back out. And he's found the end zone twice, and now I'm guessing he's thinking, hey, let's find it three times.
And you got to figure from the defensive perspective, how has he gotten there twice? What are we going to do to keep him out for a third time? How do we tighten things down? Because he and his offensive mates, they are really in sync right now.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And we'll see how they want to play this. Just a little over 20 seconds to go. And he'll just push his way forward for a few as the clock will run. There to stop him on the defensive side, Fred Warner.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
Get a timeout with 2 seconds remaining in the second quarter. Final shot before half for Rodgers. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. So we've come to halftime here with the visiting Packers out on top. As we'll send you eastward to Orlando, standing by with that EA Sports Halftime Report now is Jonathan Coachman. Take it away, Coach.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. And welcome, everyone, to this abridged version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. Okay, Brandon, thanks very much, and welcome in, everyone, to an abbreviated version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. This game's had a little bit of everything thus far, and certainly plenty to look forward to as the teams are right back out there for the second half. So we'll get right back out there as well, as we'll turn it back over to Brandon Godden.
So it's the Packers set to receive the kick. They've got the lead as well as we are underway in the third quarter. Rodgers on the return. And he brings us out past the 20 to the 24. And the Packers ready to go to start quarter number three. Rodgers will break the huddle and bring the pack up first and 10 at their own 24. The second half starts with a carry by Jones. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
44 yards rushing for him now with a couple of touchdown runs to boot.
They've got the lead early here in the third quarter, and runs like that are how they establish that lead in the first half.
I love the fact that you're using the word lead, because they are leading from the front, pounding on the defense right now with the running game, and truly establishing themselves here in the second half.
Thank you. play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. And that'll set him back 5. The delay of game backs him up 5, first and 15. Again, it's Jones. And this winds up a pickup of 2, maybe 2.5, to about the 39. And the offense moving quickly to the line. On play action, now Rodgers. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Play action. Now it's Rodgers. Looking deep for Adams. That's caught inside the 20.
Pass him in this.
Touchdown.
Pass him in this.
Packers. Devontae Adams. 61 yards. And the Packers are able to stretch that lead out further. That's a pretty quick response to that last touchdown drive, and it seemed like they had maybe given up momentum. Not so fast.
No, not at all, because they end up pushing the lead up once again, and you're exactly right. Thought momentum might have been shifting. Instead, they grabbed old Mo, didn't let him get to the opposite sideline.
Now Crosby for the point after. It's good, and it's 21-10. So that drive, 4 plays, and the result, a Green Bay score. Now after the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. And this will not be returned. It's a touchback, and they'll begin at the 25. Set to take over again here on offense, Jimmy G and the 49ers. And I guess right now, as we look at some of his struggles today, the term next play really applies here. He's got to move on.
I love where your head is on that, because that's where his head needs to be, exactly what you've said. Yes, there have been mistakes made, but he's got to move on and play the next play as if it didn't happen, keep his confidence up. But how about the guy right now? They've already gotten to him a few times. They want to keep that up. Maybe they can pick off a few more.
Well, they've disrupted already for 3 INTs. 42 yards rushing for him now in the ballgame. 8 yards the tally on that first down run. Here's 2nd and 2. They'll keep it on the ground. Mitchell. And shedding a man at the 40. And he's going to have a Niners first down as the tackle made at about the 43-yard line.
Despite the score, despite the deficit, no quitting this guy. He's running angry, running through arm tackles. He wants to change what that scoreboard is saying.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he's going to bowl his way forward to the 48. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4.
Now, Brandon, that's the way you want to run the football. There should almost be quote bubbles above the offense right now. Bam, boom, biff. That's how they feel good about moving the football.
The last run got 6, now 2nd and 4. Here's a handoff out of the gun. And this will be taken across midfield and into Green Bay territory. Call it a gain of 4 there, so it sets up a big play here, 3rd and 1 yard.
Well, if you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
And able to pick up the first across midfield to the 47. Here we go, here we go, here we go.
And they'll run on the inside handoff.
And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Adrian Amos up to make the tackle. Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. Now they'll throw with Garoppolo. Yeah, he will go out right near the 35-yard line.
And partner, they're locked in man coverage out left, and they end up running a crossing route. Rounded it a little bit more than a slant. He's just got to angle himself towards the right side of the field, and that's very difficult for a defender to shadow him across all that ground.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Throwing now is Garoppolo. Now the Packers give him nowhere to go, and they bring him down. Chris Barnes coming in hard there on the blitz, and he gets him 7 yards behind the line of scrimmage. And they brought the pressure there just right up the gut, didn't they?
Yeah, they certainly did. And, you know, when you've got so many different responsibilities as an offensive line, you got to deal with the nose tackle, the two defensive tackles or ends, and then sometimes you just can't account for everyone. The linebacker slipped free.
Don't need it all back at once, but you figure they're going to need something here. 17 yards to go on second down. Another try after the first down sack. Garoppolo. He's been quiet today in the passing game, just his second catch.
Yeah, people have to come up with schemes to limit him, and what a lot of teams do, they'll double him, you know, use a linebacker underneath, a safety over the top. Sometimes they'll just take a corner, maybe their third corner if he's a bigger guy, and put him on a man-to-man to try and limit his touches. Just keep mixing it up, give him different angles, different looks, like a good boxer does. He did a fine job there of not hitting him before the ball arrived, and I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
And did he have enough? He did. He kept it online and managed to tuck it into the bottom right corner. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Gold now out to kick it away. Rodgers going to return it from his end zone and ultimately cannot get this out to the 20. And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. The field goal we just saw has this now at a one-score game, and on this side of the football, things are getting pretty tenuous, a little stressful.
Blood pressure up a little bit, you think?
I think up a lot of it.
Could you imagine taking the pulse right now? Might be like a jackhammer out there on that side of the ball, but here's what the deal is. I think what we've observed is a team that's been playing not to lose as opposed to playing to win. And they've got to get back to that, and that means opening things up again, being a little more free in what they're trying to get done on offense.
Rodgers will bring the pack up with a first and 10 at their own 23. Off the play fake, Rodgers. He'll rifle this one deep right side. And that one a little too high as it's knocked away and incomplete. Second and 10. Now a play fake, Rodgers. Open on the left side. This is Valdez-Scantling. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Rodgers now on first down. Drops it to Jones in the flat. A good cover defensively as they get to him just beyond the 45 after the juke. It's a game of five. From the 47, it's second and 5. A give to Jones. And he stopped immediately there. They'll say no gain on the play there, and now it'll be third down.
Now, obviously, that's some good work there defensively, being able to stop them and bring up a key third down. But if you're on the offensive side of the ball, there's an opportunity, because I know what defensive guys are thinking right now. Just stop them, get to the ball. That means they might not be sound defensively. There could be some opportunities.
And you said key third down. Highlight that word. Put it in bold. Here we go. And that nearly the pick that they needed. He couldn't pull it in, though, and it's fourth down. On now is the Packers punter, as he'll punt it away for the second time. And he didn't quite have the backspin on that one. It hits at the four and continues into the end zone. It's a touchback. San Francisco set to go on offense once more. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. At least they got points.
Coach, they didn't want to drive to end with a kick. Most of them wanted to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you met fan bases that wanted that, that weren't happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants to drive to end with a kick, other than the extra point. That's it.
Garoppolo on first down. And this one brought in by Sanu. And he gets all the way down to the 30-yard line. A big play there for the Niners. Every defensive staff harps on limiting explosive plays. Job not so well done there.
Yeah, they talk about it all the time. A lot harder to stop, though, isn't it? And when you think of an explosive play, most offensive staffs define them as passes of 20 or more yards and runs of 15 or more yards.
They went zooming past that number there. So the big play has him all the way down to the 30 now for first and 10. There's Garoppolo to throw. And that is knocked away in the middle of the field and incomplete.
Quarterbacks work all the time on manipulating a defense with their eyes and their head movement. In this case, he just stared the receiver down. That allowed for excellent coverage, able to knock that one away.
Turn here, and he's going to go down. Back at about the 37-yard line. Devondre Campbell flies in to blow that play up.
Remember, he had the interception earlier. Now he adds the sack. He's really making his presence felt out there.
Well, he is putting together a heck of a game. In fact, he's going to bump these plays to his highlight reel. Okay, so he wants to show it off later on. Look what I did out there, guys. In this offense, they've got to start paying him a little special attention. He's like a good basketball player, putting stats in every column.
And Gold is able to put it through. And that'll get the lead down. An interesting call there to take the three. I mean, I guess they're thinking that their hands were tied, but, you know, fourth quarter, that field goal might not help them that much in the end.
Yeah, eventually they're going to need the touchdown. The thinking must have been they didn't feel confident about picking it up there, hoping maybe on defense they can get better field position, get a turnover, get a better play, and then they'll have a chance to attack the end zone.
And out a little across the... The Green Bay offense now about ready to take possession here. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Rodgers will break the huddle and bring the pack up first and 10 at their own 27. They'll try and run some clock now with Jones. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. 56 yards rushing for him now on what was his 10th carry of the ball game.
And when do they start thinking about burning these timeouts? They've got all three still defensively.
To me, you have to start right now. Here's the time, and that means you've got to stop them on defense, not give up the yardage, use your timeouts in order to get the ball back and try and score yourself. But now is the time to start using those timeouts.
And keep in mind, it'll also stop the clock at the 2-minute warning. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. To throw is Rodgers. This one swung out here to Jones. They'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. It looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. They fake the give. Now Rodgers. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. So it's Packer football here as we welcome you back. They've got a second down now. He's going to rifle one deep left side. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
Trying to get that one to his tight end, and they've been trying to get the ball to him, but as of yet, unable to successfully complete one. But you know, there's usually a nice comfort zone in throwing to the tight end. Great sight lines, usually right in the middle of the field.
An important play right here, third and 10.
And I would expect pressure here.
Back to throw, Rodgers. Looking deep for Adams. Got a man, it's caught at the 6-yard line. And he'll go out of bounds, making it all the way down to the 5. A big play there, Rodgers to Adams. 41 yards. It's first and goal and a late touchdown at this stage. Could officially salt this one away. Now Rodgers. And this is caught. And that could seal it. It's a touchdown. There was no going through the progressions on that touchdown pass.
Yeah, nor was it necessary. His receiver won that route early, presented himself. No reason to wait. Go ahead and put it on him and score a touchdown.
And now it appears that the referee's been buzzed, and we'll get a review of this being inside 2 minutes of play. Everything coming from up above. They're taking a peek at whether or not those feet were in bounds, and obviously a big call here in the end zone.
And not just the feet. How about the hands? How is the ball possessed while the feet are hopefully getting down in bounds? That's what they're trying to look at to see if it all comes together.
So they called it a touchdown originally, and this will stay a touchdown after the video review, so they had it right. Crosby connects on the extra point, and it gives his guys a 12-point advantage. Now after the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. And this will not be returned. It'll come out to the 25. Garoppolo and the Niners now. Down by 12. A minute 40 remaining. How will this thing pan out? We'll watch as they come up on first down. First down, Garoppolo. That's over the middle and caught by Ayuk. He'll be dropped after a gain of about six across the 30 to the 31. And this is caught, Jennings. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. Now after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. While he gets attended to, we'll step aside. Throwing on first is Garoppolo. That's going to be caught by Samuel. And this winds up a gain of four to the 41. And we've reached the one-minute mark in this game. And he's dropped just before the line to gain. Four-yard pickup leaves him with third and one. Now a play fake. Garoppolo. Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a first down. Clock management definitely critical here if they want to get back in this game.
Absolutely agreed. They have to up the tempo in this case, down a couple of scores. Want to make sure they have a chance to win this ball game.
So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. Inside the red zone, it's Garoppolo. And this is caught for a touchdown. So hang on now. Things just got a little bit more interesting here in the final minute. Okay, game on. Don't go anywhere yet. You got a one-score game now. Probably going to rely on the onside kick coming up.
Yeah, they have to. It's not a high percentage play, but it's better than not having a chance at all. And that's when you put your leapers and your flyers on one side. Get that high.
And now remember, all touchdowns are reviewed. And in a tight game like this, they're going to take a good long look at it. They're taking a peek at whether or not those feet were in bounds. And obviously a big call here in the end zone.
And not just the feet. How about the hands? How's the ball possessed while the feet are hopefully getting down in bounds? That's what they're trying to look at to see if it all comes together.
So the folks in New York just going to wind up confirming what the official saw as this play will stand as is. Called able to tack on the extra point. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. So still a small chance here with a little over 30 seconds to go, but they're definitely going to need this one to bounce their way. And this is going to be recovered by the hands team. And that should just about put a capper on this one. Well, fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we've brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of an anecdotal type of a number. Kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Rodgers looking to throw. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. Now San Francisco going to call their second timeout as they get it with just 19 seconds left on the clock. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. And this is caught. And that could seal it. It's a touchdown.
And that touchdown should make you feel comfortable But do you really feel like it's totally over yet?
Not totally, but I think you're pretty much there.
Yeah, you still got to make sure you stay with it, do all the right things down the stretch, especially on defense. But that touchdown there, you've got to feel good about your chances.
Extra point try now for Crosby. He's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. Scoring summary, 3-play drive, and it ends with a Packers touchdown. Now after the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. And he'll just take a seat, and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. They can't do much at this point, partner. This one is going to go down in the loss column.
You don't make up for what has happened during the game in this sequence here. Maybe you hand it off and let someone run the ball if you so choose. But otherwise, just kneel down, call it a day, and try and prepare going forward.
So quickly, all the way up at the 40-yard line. Looking to throw, Garoppolo. He's going to let it fly. And that is intercepted, or was it? Wait, they'll say no. No interception. He did not keep the feet in bounds, apparently. So that's just going to be an incompletion. Oh, a desperation throw deep downfield. Oh, I'm not sure he saw the linebacker there, as that's batted down and incomplete. Charles, we saw a lot of points go up in this one. Certainly defensively, stuff that they can look at on film, don't you think?
No doubt about it. And they've got to go back and check where the errors are, how they're going to fix them, and continue to get better at what they do. But they also need a little adjustment with their confidence. To give up that many points, even if you win a game, that can hurt you.
For my partner, Charles Davis, and the best darn crew in the industry, I'm Brandon Gaughton. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. And we'll get ready for the trek back to the city as we say so long from Santa Clara.
Oh, what a great city it is. We're going to have a blast tonight.